Hi, my name is Andrea. I'm a certified Take Shape for Life health coach. I had a request from one of my clients to do a few more lean and green videos. She finds herself being a little bit stuck at night when she's at her hungriest and she doesn't have food prepared. And so what I'm going to do is I'm not necessarily going to lay out a lean and green video and like prepare the whole thing for you right now, but I am going to show you what I have done over the past 2 days to do a lean and green. Because my children don't eat the same way I eat, and because my husband and I rarely eat together during the week, also because I work from home, I have the ability to be very careful when I'm planning my lean and greens. I have a friend named Gary. He is also a Take Shape for Life health coach, and he also has a channel. I'm gonna link his channel right there. He does a lot of lean and green videos. And so if you ever needed to, watch somebody do some lean and greens, he's fabulous. You could also go to Sandy's Kitchen Adventures. She's a good friend of mine. And she has a blog. She doesn't do videos, but she has a blog and she has lean and green recipes. I prefer to work without recipes. That's just the way I am. That's the way my mom taught me how to cook, and that's the way I cook. I use my crock pot definitely more often in the cold months. I still use it in the summer months too, but I did use my crock pot yesterday in order to make my lean and green for last night. I knew that my husband was not going to be home for dinner. This particular meal was for me and my children. But I made a lot of it because I knew that I could stick the leftovers into the fridge. You can also put this into the freezer, but here it is. Now this has corn in it. I am not in the active weight loss phase, so I can have a little bit of corn. And this does have one small can of Del Monte Summer Crisp canned corn. I believe that's what it's called. I prefer frozen vegetables, but I didn't have any corn in my freezer. And I knew that I always have cans of corn in my cabinet because my kid loves corn. And because I knew that my kids were going to be eating this, I went ahead and put corn in it. This is taco meat. I wouldn't necessarily call it a chili because it doesn't have any beans in it. But we call this taco meat in my house. This is 85/15 chopped beef. It has one packet of Old El Paso low sodium taco seasoning. One can of no salt diced tomatoes. One small can of corn, one half of an orange bell pepper chopped up super, super small because I needed my kids to eat it. And it's got some vegetable in it. It's not enough vegetable for them. I try to do celery sticks on the side, carrot sticks, a little bit of broccoli, something like that. But this was the bulk of what they ate last night. I put it into a little bowl after it's cooked in this thing for about 6 hours on low. I didn't have to brown anything. I didn't have to dirty up my stove, nothing. And now I have all of this left over because I ate it, the kids ate it, and now this is what was left over. So now what am I gonna do with this? I'm gonna keep this in my fridge for a solid 5 or 7 days. It's gonna be fine. It's got that protective layer of fat on it that we all have at this time of year. Friday's dinner is going to be this warmed up over a bed of spaghetti squash. I went ahead and took advantage of the fact that it was 9 o'clock in the morning and my house was nice and quiet. I hacked this thing in half. Now the spaghetti squash, if you've never cooked spaghetti squash, you have to, okay? Spaghetti squash is fabulous even if you don't like pasta because it doesn't really taste like pasta, it just gives you that pasta feel, okay? I cut these things in half. And then I roast it. I know a lot of people roast it and then they cut it in half and then they roast it again. I don't do that. It takes a little bit of strength to cut a spaghetti squash in half. If you do it neatly, you're already at an advantage. I ended up doing this one pretty good. So I cut it in half. I take the seeds out. I scrape the seeds out with a regular spoon. I sprayed the inside with this. I probably used about 2 tablespoons total because I sprayed the entire half, both halves, so that they were like glistening, okay, with this. I sprinkled about, in total, a teaspoon of this over both halves. This is the light adobo, so it's less salt than regular adobo, because regular adobo is crazy salty. And then I put a generous amount, probably a solid tablespoon, of the salt-free Mrs. Dash. Almost all Mrs. Dash things, I think, are salt-free. This is just the straight table blend, because sometimes I don't know if I'm going to go Italian, I don't know if I'm going to go Mexican, I don't know if I'm going to go Chinese, I don't know if I'm going to go Thai. In the style of cooking that I'm gonna use the spaghetti squash in. So I feel like this is a nice generic, no salt seasoning. And so I put it in the oven at 350. on some tinfoil. An hour and 15 minutes, I think. I know it's done when I can do this. With very little effort. I might have left it in there 5 minutes too long, but it's fine. It's absolutely fine. If you undercook this stuff, I don't like it. I don't like it if it's undercooked, because then it has a crunch to it, it gets stuck in your teeth, and you're still trying to fake yourself into thinking that you're eating pasta, right? Once that cools off completely, what I'll do is I'll get a big bowl, and I will scrape all of the insides into a big bowl. And I will also take it and kind of like break it up a little bit so that it really is strands of spaghetti. And so then I have this big bowl in my fridge of roasted, prepped spaghetti squash that I can then add to any meal that I need vegetables in, okay? You can also add spaghetti squash to some of your Medifast meals if you're looking to break up your lean and green. If you're on the 5-in-1, you're only allowed a certain amount of vegetables per day. If you're in transition, you need to add more vegetables to your diet. This is a great way to do it because you're adding it to your meal replacements, okay? Soups, chili, that kind of thing. So how much spaghetti squash are you allowed? According to Medifast and Take Shape for Life, this is the chart. Either this chart or this chart. They say the same thing. This one is color-coded, this one is not. They are color-coded for the level of carbohydrate that they have. Red or pink is the highest, yellow is the medium, and green is the lowest in carbohydrates. So you want to try to stay in the green as often as possible. But this is a really good vegetable dish, okay? And it unfortunately is in the pinks. Nobody gets fat eating a lot of vegetables. But this is a little higher carbohydrate. Spaghetti squash, 77.5 grams is one serving. So times three, you're talking about approximately 250 grams of spaghetti squash as your daily allotment, okay? I wouldn't recommend going all the way on spaghetti squash every day of the week. I know it would be tempting, but there's no chlorophyll in here. This is not a green leafy vegetable. I say that you can't get fat eating vegetables, but if you ate too much of this, you will not lose the weight that you probably want to lose, okay? So what I would do is I would probably do one or two servings of this. If you took out the corn, the tomatoes in here are probably not really enough for a serving either, because it was one can in the whole kit and caboodle. Is that amount of diced tomatoes with no salt worth counting? Maybe not. Maybe it's a quarter of a vegetable serving. Maybe it's a half. It depends on how much meat you used. I can't tell you how much to do because I'm not your coach, okay? If you want me to be your coach, I can. But even then, I'm probably gonna tell you that you need to get out a calculator and get out a scale for the first couple of weeks, or maybe even the first couple of months, until you get the hang of how much you're supposed to eat of each food, okay? If you follow the rules, this program works. If you don't follow the rules, you run the risk of the program not working. And then you feel like you're working really hard and you're not getting any benefit from it. You might as well do these little tasks. It's not that it makes it easier. It's just time consuming. It's not more difficult. It's just time consuming. But it makes it so that you get the result from the plan, right? Okay. Yes, I still do weigh my food all the time because I don't trust my eyes. I just don't. My eyes are huge. My portion control is still really, it needs a lot of work. And it might always, and that's okay. If I always have to have a scale in my kitchen, that's fine. My lean and green for this and this would be about 150 grams of this, 4.5 ounces of this, and then maybe just a little bit of salad on the side. Okay? That's what I would do. But now I have all of this spaghetti squash sitting in my fridge waiting for me to need it. I have all of this prepared lean and a little bit of green waiting for me to need it. If I go off plan, it has to be because I'm refusing to eat this and this together. And by the way, this and this together is delicious. You put some of this onto a plate, you put some of this on top of it, like a bed of it, and then you throw it in the microwave. That's it. That's it. It's delicious. It's kind of like a Mexican take on spaghetti with meat sauce, right? Okay. So that's one lean and green idea to use your crock pot, your oven, no pans, no dishes to be done other than the dish that you're going to eat off of, and you're making it all in advance so that you have no excuse to go off plan. but you'll probably still make an excuse to go off plan, and that's okay. But it's not gonna be this one. It's not gonna be that there was nothing to eat, because this is delicious. And everything is already seasoned, everything is already done. We have to just throw it together. My name is Andrea. I'm a certified Take Shape for Life health coach. If you have any questions about this, you can hit me up. All of my information is below. Talk to you later. Bye.